Hi, in the last few lecture we discussed about how we can use operational amplifier for different applications. Like we have looked at how we can use it for summation, for subtraction. Now we are going to look at how we can use this operational amplifier for more complex applications like differentiation and integration. So as you know that for all those applications that we discussed, we use inverting amplifier. So this is the circuit for inverting amplifier. In an inverting amplifier, we give an input to an inverting terminal through a resistance R1, and we connected a feedback resistance RF. And if you do something like this, then the output voltage Vout is given by minus RF upon R1 into Vin, where minus RF upon R1 is the gain of this particular amplifier. And in order to derive this particular gain, we use these two concepts. First, we use the concept of virtual ground. So if I connect a non-inverting terminal to ground, then at the inverting terminal the potential will be zero. And the second concept is that since there is no current flowing through the operational amplifier, as it has a infinite input impedance, the current I1 has to be equal to current IF, where I1 is the current flowing through R1 and IF is the current flowing through RF. So we are going to make use of this concept as well. So let's look how we can use it as a differentiator. So operational amplifier as a differentiator. So what I need is the output voltage Vout should be proportional to the differentiation time derivative of input voltage. So that's what I expect when I use operational amplifier as a differentiator. So now if I'm going to use it as a in this particular case also I'm going to use a modified form of inverting amplifier. So if I use the inverting amplifier, that time Vout is equal to minus RF upon R1 Vin. So I need to convert this particular minus RF upon R1 in terms of differentiation of input voltage. So how I can do that? For that, we are going to use, instead of R1, we are going to use a capacitor over there. So if I use a capacitor over here, and this is an inverting terminal, this is a non-inverting terminal, this is grounded, and there is a resistance over here. So this is R, and I am applying our input voltage Vin over here, and the output voltage will be Vout. And obviously there will be some current flowing through this particular resistance. I am going to call it as IF, and there will be some current flowing from over here, which I am going to call that I1. So I am going to again use this particular version, I1 is equal to IF. So I need to find out what is the value of I1 and what is the value of IF. As you know that since at this particular point A, the potential is zero, the voltage appearing across R1 is minus Vout. So IF will be equal to, from Ohm's law, minus Vout divided by RF. We have denoted it by R over here. So this will be R. Now what will be I? In order to find the value of I, what I'm going to use, I'm going to use a concept of capacitor. Now, across this capacitor, what is the voltage? The potential over here is zero, the potential over here is Vin. So the potential across this resistance is equal to Vin. Potential across this capacitor is Vin. So I have applied a potential of Vin across a capacitor C. So from the equation of capacitor, I know that C is equal to Q by V. So if I put the value of V over here, which is equal to Vin, so this will be C is equal to Q by Vin. So I have Vin is equal to C, Vin is equal to Q. And what is current? I? I is nothing but rate of change of charge, dq by dt. So if I differentiate it, what I'm going to get? C is a capacitance, which is constant number, so this will be C dV in by dt is equal to my I, right? No, or rather I1, let me call it as I1. And if I now compare, I1 is equal to IF, what I'm going to get? I'm going to get C dV in by dt is equal to minus V out by R. So V out will be equal to R into C dV in by dt with a minus sign, obviously. So as you can see, you are getting output voltage as a differentiation of input voltage. If I put, let's say, R is equal to 1 mega ohm and capacitance is equal to 1 micro farad, that time R into C will be equal to 1, and I am going to get V out is equal to minus dV in by dt. So the output voltage will be differentiation of input voltage. So simply by replacing the input resistance by a capacitance, I can convert this inverting amplifier circuit into a differentiator circuit. So in order to convert a inverting amplifier circuit into a differentiator circuit, I just need to replace the input resistance by a capacitor. Now let's look into detail of this particular thing. So now what's going to happen if I have, let's say, if the applied voltage is DC voltage, so whatever we have, V in is equal to some constant value, DC is constant value, so what will be the V out? So V out, as we know, that it is minus RC dV in by dt, and since V in is constant, so V out will be equal to minus RC into d some constant into dt, and differentiation constant is 0, so V out will be equal to 0. So if I apply a DC voltage to a differentiator circuit, then the output will be 0. What is going to happen if the voltage is AC voltage? I have applied AC voltage. If I have a AC voltage, then V in will be equal to V sine omega t, where V is the peak voltage that I'm going to get, and sine omega is the frequency, angular frequency, and t is the time. So V out will be equal to minus RC d by dt of V sine omega t. As this V is the peak voltage, which is some constant number, so I'm going to get V out is equal to minus RC V d by dt of sine omega t. And if I differentiate this particular thing, I'm going to get minus RCV into cos omega t, and differentiation of omega t will differentiation of sine omega t is cos omega t, and differentiation of omega t will be omega. So as you can see over here, V out, R is constant, C is constant, V is constant, and this is some varying quantity. So V out will be proportional to frequency. So the amplitude of output voltage will depend on frequency. If I have a higher frequency, then the amplification will be larger. If I have a lower frequency, then the amplification will be lower. Right? So let's try to look at what's going to happen if I have different input signals. So the first thing, what is going to happen if I fed some DC voltage to a differentiator? What I'm going to get as output? So this is input. I fed a DC voltage to a differentiator circuit. What will be my output? My output will be 0 volt. Right? And what's going to happen if I have, let's say, a sine wave, something like this? And if I fed it to a differentiator, what will be my output? My output will be minus of cos omega t, and the amplitude will depend on the frequency. So minus of cos omega t, so it will be something like this. And obviously the amplitude will depend on frequency. Next thing is, what's going to happen if I fade something like this, a square wave, to a differentiator? What will be my output? So now, at this particular point, when the voltage is increasing, since this voltage is increasing, it is changing. So there will be an increase in output voltage. And then, the voltage is remaining constant after some that point. So when the voltage is constant, what I'm going to get? I'm going to get zero. So initially, the voltage will increase, and then it will swiftly decrease to zero, and it will remain zero up to this particular point. And then it will go on to some negative value. So again, it will it has to be negative. So it will be something like, let me draw it below over here. For this particular corresponding point, this will be something like this, and then it will go to zero, and then it will go to positive value, and then it will reduce to some zero value. And from this particular point again, it will go to zero. So it will be some spike voltages, something like this. And this is negative because I'm going to have some positive and negative voltages, that's why. Instead of this, if I have only this particular signal, something like this, where this value is the 0 volt value, then my output will be correspondingly will be zero volt, then my output voltage correspondingly will be something like this. This is 0 volt. So this is my input and this will be my output. So if I input a square wave, I'm going to get some spikes. What is going to happen if I give an input as a triangular wave? So suppose if I have triangular wave as an input, something like this, what is going to be my output voltage? So at this particular point, as it is increasing in a positive direction, I'm going to have some negative voltage. And at this particular point, it is constant, so it will be zero. So as it is linearly increasing, the output will be constant. As you can see, the slope is constant over here, so the differentiation will be some constant number. Then at this particular point, it is going to change its shape and it will be constant negative slope. The slope is negative, so this will be something like this. And again, for this positive slope, I'm going to have some negative value. So if I have an input voltage as a triangular wave, my output voltage will be a square wave. So in a differential amplifier, if I give a constant DC voltage as an input, my output will be zero. If I have a sine wave as an input, my output will be a cosine wave. If I give a square wave as an input, I'm going to get spikes as my output. And if I have a triangular wave as my input, I'm going to get square wave as my output. So hope you understood this particular thing. Now, let's talk about the next circuit, which is integrator. So, how we can use operational amplifier as an integrator. So, what I expect that the output voltage is proportional to integration of Vin dt. So again we are going to use the inverting amplifier circuit. So the circuit similar to this particular circuit. And I know this is Vin and this is Vout. Now in the differentiator case, I replace the input resistance by a capacitor and I got differentiation. Now in integrator, I am going to replace this feedback resistance by a capacitor. So the integrator circuit will look something like this. So this is my R, inverting terminal, non-inverting terminal, ground, and I have a capacitor over here, and I have input of voltage over Vin and output voltage will be Vo. Now at this particular point A, the voltage is zero. So the voltage across this capacitor A is V out, rather minus V out is the voltage across capacitor C. So this is the capacitor C. Therefore, from C is equal to Q by V out. Therefore, V out will be equal to Q by C, and I know that my I is equal to dQ by dt. So therefore, Q will be equal to integration of I dt. Correct? So V out will be equal to integration of I dt. Right? This is the current. What is this current? This is the current which is flowing through this resistance R, because that is the current going to flow through the capacitor. So this is my I. And what is that value of this I? If I look over here, the value of I will be equal to V in by R. So if I put the value of I in this particular equation, I'm going to get V out will be equal to there has to be a minus sign over here, because V out, minus V out is there. So minus V out is equal to integration of V in by R into C, Q by C. So integration I dt divided by C. So there has to be some C value over here with a minus sign. Yeah. So the output voltage V out is equal to minus of 1 divided by RC integration of V in dt. That is the value that I am going to get. So if I replace the feedback resistance by a capacitor, I can use the inverting amplifier as a integrator. Right? Now let's look at what's going to happen if I have applied a DC voltage to an integrator. So DC voltage means some constant voltage. So if Vin is equal to some constant voltage, then V out, which is minus 1 over RC integration Vin dt, so that would be minus 1 over RC into some constant value into dt. So that will be, let's say this constant value is V, so minus V upon RC integration of dt. So that would be minus V upon RC into T. So if I applied a constant voltage, DC voltage, then my V out will be proportional to T. So as the time goes on, the voltage goes on increasing. Will it increase forever? No. After some time, it will start saturating and it will remain constant at a saturated voltage. Right? So this will be the output. This is the time axis. So that's what going to happen when you have applied a DC voltage. What's going to happen if I apply a AC voltage? So if I have a AC voltage, V in will be equal to V, let's say Vm, or just V sine omega t. So V out, which is equal to minus 1 over RC V sine omega t integration with dt. So this will be minus V upon RC, because V is constant. Integration of sine omega t will be equal to minus of cos omega t divided by omega. Right? So this V out will be proportional to 1 over omega. So larger the frequency, smaller will be the amplitude of the output voltage. Exactly opposite of the differentiator. In differentiator, for differentiator, we have seen that V out is proportional to omega. So larger the frequency, larger will be the output voltage. In case of integrator, V out is proportional to 1 over omega. So this is integrator circuit. So V out is proportional to 1 over omega. So larger the frequency, smaller will be the output voltage. So let's look at some different types of wavefront that we are going to get when we have integrator. So if I have an integrator and if I apply a constant voltage, if I fade it to an integrator, what I'm going to get? I'm going to get something like this voltage. Then if I apply a AC voltage, let's say a sine wave, something like this, and I have fed it to an integrator, what I'm going to get? I'm going to get a cos wave. So I'm going to get something like this, isn't it? Then if I fed, let's say, a square wave, what I'm going to get? If I fed a square wave of this type to an integrator, now as this voltage is increasing, right over here, as time passes, it will be a linearly increasing function, and when it is a constant, it will be a linear function. So if I have something like this, some wave, something like this as an input voltage, then as output I am going to get some linearly increasing thing for this constant voltage over here up to this particular point. It will be constant, then it is reducing, and again I am going to have, this is zero, so this is negative voltage, so it will be something like this up to this particular point, then increasing, again decreasing, increasing, decreasing. So if I give an input as a square wave, I'm going to get a triangular wave as output. So these are the different wavefront that I'm going to get if I have a differentiator and integrator. I hope you understand this particular circuit. Thank you for your time.